Hello and welcome back. It's a beautiful morning outside. It's cold, but hey, even in this weather, I still like iced tea, but I know it's gonna be more beautiful during the summer. So I'm gonna show you how I make my lemon cucumber infused iced tea. I didn't want to go through the process of just chopping my cucumber, so I just did this. This is my lemon and cucumber. I sliced it, put it in water overnight, and this is it. All right, we'll set that aside. And then I want to talk a little bit about my tea. Now, in my iced tea, I like using, you can use any tea you want. You can actually even mix and match and find out what works for you. Sometimes I use my tea leaf, but I like the Kenyan tea. I always love the Kenyan tea. I don't know why. It tastes different. It tastes just different. All right. So this is a brand a friend gave to me. It's like Kericho Gold. That I like using that. This is what it looks like. Let me just get it out. This is what it looks like. And then green tea. I also like adding green tea to my black tea, iced black tea. Sometimes I mix and match depending on the green tea that I have. I use peppermint tea, gives it flavor. And then there's this honey lemon ginseng tea that I also use. It has green tea, white tea, and some, apart from the lemon honey flavors with other natural flavors, ginger, ascorbic acid. Apart from all of those, I also like the taste. So for this much lemon, that is one lemon, one lime, and about one large cucumber that I soaked in that water. So about that, I will be using two of this. This is what it looks like. And it smells good. Be using two of that. And then I had already brought out my tea. I have about six of the Kenyan tea. Two or three of the Tazo, then about four or so of my peppermint tea. It's just basically for the flavor, for the peppermint flavor, and then some green tea and two of this. So to my water, what I really do is these things. I just measure the water because I like doing my tea concentrated because of the icing. So I like making it concentrated. But if you're not going to use it on ice, you could just add water later on. It's better to make it concentrated so that it starts better. So I just take out the paper from it so that I don't have to boil that. I think I'm going to add more water. Whilst my tea is boiling, I'm going to sieve my lemon ginger mix. I actually do like sieving again with my coffee filter to be sure. Look at that color. Man, this Kenyan tea, even the color is different. It's like, I don't know. All right, so I think it has boiled enough. I'm going to bring it down and allow it to cool down before I continue with the next process, because I don't just take out the tea bags, I actually squeeze them when I bring them out. So I have it has cooled down, they're both cold. I have strained the tea. Well, most times I like straining it twice, especially with my coffee filter, it makes it easier. So we don't even really need to do much. I just mix it in. I leave a little because I have to do something with that. Now this is I buy it from bulk supplement. This is your absorbic acid. Absorbic acid is vitamin C. Practically, it helps gives it a fullness. I don't know how to describe it, but when I used to do like Zobo in Nigeria, I use it a lot. So I'm just going to add about like a teaspoon to it. Has to mix in properly. So now when you have it like this, you practically have your unsweetened black tea, your unsweetened ice tea. You just need to add in your ice, and you can have it like this if you want it on sweetened. Even like this, it doesn't really need sweetener per se. But the best way I enjoy my tea is, if you're not keto and you want to use your sugar, your honey, your sweetener, whatever, this is now time you do it. But what I do is I kind of store it unsweetened. I have all these beautiful containers. This is the one I use if I want to just have it on the go. I fill it in this container, top it with some ice or water, and I'm good to go. Now, why I like storing it unsweetened is I like sweetening mine with some electrolyte powder. And this thing has like about 5 to 6, 7 different flavors. So if I put one flavor here, I'm just gonna be shortchanging myself. So I store it unsweetened. So for any time and every time, I can decide to swish it up and have my green tea, different flavors, different, you know, variety. Is the spice of life. So we're gonna store it unsweetened, and when I am ready, So I'm just gonna store it unsweetened. Whenever I decide, I just add whatever flavor that takes my fancy. But you could also use just plain stevia if you want. All right, so thank you for watching. I hope you try it and tell me how it turns out. And I will see you in my next video. Bye.